So let's see this question. Minimize the following function using K-map. 0, 4, 8, 12. Correct? So the most important point in K-map is first thing is the numbering. Okay. How to number? That is our first important thing in this. So we had number from 0, 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. Then come to the last row, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Okay, I think it's not visible here. Yeah, no, it's fine. 8, 9, 10 and then 11. Then go to the third row, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So totally there are 16 elements starting from 0. Fine. Then come back to the question respectively. What is our question here? 0, 4, 8, 12. Correct? So 0, 4, 8, 12 in the sense, 0 I will mark it as what? 1 itself. I'll mark it as 1 here. Here also I'll mark it as what? Here I'll mark it as 1. 0, 4, 8, 12. So I marked everywhere as 1. Correct? If there are 2 terms or 4 terms or 8 terms or 16 terms, that is the power of 2. 2 power n, when n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I can do what? I can put a circle. I can map them. That is what it's called K-mapping. Correct. So only these elements, what I do the mapping here. Once I have mapped this thing, then what I will do, once I have mapped it, then what I will do is, I will see what is the common here. W bar X bar is there, W bar X is there, WX, WX bar. There is nothing common in these things. Correct. So these things I cannot take. Then which is other thing here, Y bar, Z bar. So this is the only common term. So which means our answer is what? Y bar, Z bar. That's all. It's a very easy thing to do here. So we'll just verify our answer. Y bar, Z bar. That's it. Our answer is Y bar, Z bar respectively. We got it. Now that was our SOP, sigma, sum of products, okay? SOP, sum of products. Now POS, product of sum. So let's see a similar problem on product of sum also. Yes, we can see one problem here. In product of sum POS, they will be giving something called pi. In sum of products, they will give sigma. Sigma for what? SOP, sum of products. So how do we identify it is pi, it is a POS. If it is sigma, it is SOP. Let's see this thing. Same way only. Correct. But the only difference here is, let's see this thing. What is the difference? 0, 1, 3, 5, 6, 7, 10, 14, 15. 0, so instead of in the last one, we have put 1 here. Here we'll be putting is what? Here we'll be putting 0, 0. Then here also 0, 0. Then in 5, I will put 6, I will put 7. 7 is here. Yeah, already I have put in that. Then 10 is here. 14 and 15. 14 is here. 15 is here. Same method only. What I do use here? The squaring the term. Squaring. One term I squared here. The other term is these things I can square. Correct? And this is one more term which I can square. Then this one also I can put square. Correct? Now what I have to see is in this term, in these two terms which is common here, C is common. C plus D bar and C plus D and C plus D bar, which is common here? C is common. Here what is common? A plus B is common. So A plus B and C. So A plus B into C will be our first term here. Or else we can go down and let's see the same thing. So pair one, we got A plus B plus C, correct? Oh, anyway, it's going down. Let's put back this to our original position income. Since it is a product of sums A plus B plus C, for which term? It is for this term. Here, what is common? C plus D and C plus D bar. C is common, so that's the reason I put here plus C. And here, obviously, A plus B is there. This particular thing. That's all. Let's take for this square bracket. For this square bracket, D bar is common. C plus D bar and C bar plus D bar. D bar is common. Here, which is common for these two things? A is common, so A plus D bar. Now I'll write that also. Next one is A plus, I'll write it here, A plus D bar. The next one which I'm going to see is which one? This four brackets, this four thing. In these things which is common here, B bar is common, fine. And these above things which is common here, C bar is common. So B bar plus C bar. Now here, which is the one common here? A bar is common. And here, what is common here? C bar plus D. So A bar plus C bar plus D. That's it. A bar plus C bar plus D. Now let's see what is our answer finally. This product of sum, which means I have to multiply everything. Okay, now I'm clearing all of this stuff. Yeah. Correct. So whatever we got, we have to multiply and give it. That's it. So whatever we have got previously in this, we have to just multiply and write on the answers product of sum. So this is as simple as that. So let's see in sum of products, any more sum is there, SOP. Here we get one more thing. This is summation here, correct? So they have put already one, everything they actually put here, one, one. I'm just putting here. Then mark it, correct? Four things I can mark at a time. That is this thing, correct? Then what? Then these four things I can mark. Then these four things I can mark. But if I do that, then what about this? I also have to mark. Correct. So if this is complex, if this is complex here, what I will do is, I'll first mark this term alone. Okay, what is the answer of this? Only AB is coming. Only AB is coming. Because nothing is common in this. That's the reason. Only AB. Now if I am marking this particular thing, the top one, CD is coming here. Correct, AB plus CD. Then what is coming next after that? CD is coming and this is coming. What is common in these two things? In these two things, the common is B. BCD. AB plus BCD. Then I am going to mark this particular thing. In this thing, A is coming common and C is coming common. Plus AC. Plus, here also I have to take care of this thing. Here also I'm getting A common and here I'm getting D common plus AD. So this is my final answer. AB plus AC plus AD plus BCD. So these are the four quadrants which I'm getting. But let's see the final thing here. Okay. So without canceling anything, I'm just going to the top. Correct. So here also given BCD plus AB plus AD plus AC. So just same as the answer which I have told. So in an array, okay, in an array, let's take this particular thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. In a two-dimensional array, what is this thing? This is my first row. First row. This is my first column. Second row, third row. First column, second column, third column. So I'll write it here as row 1, row 2, row 3. Column 1, column 2, column 3. Correct. So in a two-dimensional array, if array is A, this will be which one? This will be row. This will be which one? Column. So, one. This is what element in array? This is first row, first column. Correct? So I can put here 1, 1. What is A11 value? 1 itself. Suppose if it is what? Second row, correct? Second row, first column. Second row, R2, and this is what? Column 1. Second row, first column. What is the value? 4. Now let me take this 9. What is this 9? Row 3, correct? And column 3. So this is nothing but what? A33, the value is what? 9. The same thing only in the question paper they have also mentioned here. Correct. 1, 2, 3. This is my 0, 0 they have put here. Correct. Whatever value we want, we can put here. So I have taken here what? First row, first column. Second, this is A12. Correct. But here they have taken this as 0, 1, 2. Which means the column has started from where? Row has started from 0, 1 and 2nd. Column also started from 0, 1 and 2nd. So this is 0, 0. That same thing only they are written here. Whatever value we want, we can put it here. But whatever is there inside this, they put. That's all. It's a very easy thing to